Good evening, guys. I'm back and I'm back with a very quick analysis or crypto analysis, just looking at Bitcoin specifically. And I don't know, I'm just here to kind of like, you know, just repeat what I've been saying the last couple of weeks. If you've seen my analysis since on Bitcoin since November, I think it was November 23rd, I've been sharing. And actually from here, this was 22nd November when I first marked out my chart. As you can see, I haven't deleted anything from this chart. I've left everything just so that everyone can see the progress. And, you know, so this since this candle here on the 22nd of November, I've been very bearish on BTC. And we can see at this point in time, we were at 58.5K. And today we are at 35K. We actually hit 34K. I think it was yesterday or this early this morning, Sunday. I mean, this is Kenyan time morning. And I mean, guys, this is quite a distance. I mean, since November 22nd, now we are in, it's literally 2 months. The last 2 months, we've just been bearish on this pair. And I know a lot of people have been thinking, oh yeah, BTC is gonna go up and go up. And I've been saying, no, there's a lot of liquidity resting down here. So I've told guys, I mean, I've been saying 30K, 30K, I've been saying 30K, and we are 4,000 away from 30K, which is around here. I mean, and we may even go below that. But I mean, there's so much liquidity. There's a lot of sell side liquidity downside. So I know there are people who want to buy this, who want the market to start buying. But what I'd say is if you are just investing and buying to hold, this is a good time to start accumulating more Bitcoin. But you have to also do it strategically. Don't just start buying in bulk because I don't think the down move is yet done. And you don't want to get to a point whereby you bought too early. Okay, there's also that thing of buying too early, which is what I see people doing as soon as, you know, everyone is like, yeah, to the moon, 100K, 100K. And I'm like, and I realize when I listen to all these people who talk about cryptocurrency sometimes, all respect to everyone who's participating in the space, but to some extent, sometimes and what I gather is just from just my own my humble observation is that a lot of these people are not traders, so they don't really know how to read the charts and are more stuck on the fundamental side of the crypto. So yes, fundamentally Bitcoin is a really good coin to invest in, you know, in terms of its metrics, its tokenomics, I mean everything surrounding Bitcoin as a coin, its viability as a coin, as a digital currency is actually good. However, I think sometimes if you just look at the chart alone, it's very easy to also be able to tell the bias. So right now, what we can see is that Bitcoin is at a demand zone. The reason why you can see this mini retracement, and I don't know how the daily, it's looking on the daily, so yeah, we can see this retracement, okay? And the reason being, we actually got to the to a demand zone. So that's where we are at. So this is technically not a bad place to buy, okay? This is actually a good place to buy, but short term. So my take would be that we would see a minor retracement, maybe back to the 38 zone, before we continue to the downside, okay? Because I feel like this supply area is very strong because it pushed the price down so aggressively that it broke structure, internal structure here, okay? But as we can see, we are very bearish. We've just been scaling lower highs, lower highs, lower highs. And this would have been a hint as soon as we took out this highs here. We took out liquidity. We took out this previous high of April 2021, and then we shifted up and took out the all-time high of October 2021. And then we just broke down. Once this breakdown happened, I don't know why people still thought that Bitcoin was going to just start going up. Okay. I mean, for sure, this rally to the top side is actually a good indication for, you know, a potential buy. But, okay, in terms of, I mean, when you see, when we saw it break out above here, this was a good opportunity to buy. But if really you want to buy anything, whether you're buying land, whether you're buying house, whether you're buying, you know, whatever it is you're buying, even if you go to the groceries or to the market to buy veggies, you want to buy when the price is at a discount. You don't want to be buying when the price is premium. So if you're buying at this level, anyone who was buying up here and got liquidated, it's almost like it's your fault because you were buying at premium prices. Okay. So now that we are in more discounted prices, it is viable to actually want to buy at this premium discounted levels. But please note that we do have liquidity, sell side liquidity, a lot of it still sitting below. So I think, you know, if we may even just see a major liquidity grab happen, which I don't really want to happen, because if that happens, that means whatever retracement happens will have to clear the imbalance of that liquidity grab. So I like what I'm seeing here in terms of the gradual drop in Bitcoin, because then it means that when the rise begins, it's going to be very firm and it'll be a nice rally to the upside. So there's a mini, we are in a demand zone on the weekly, and I don't know how long we'll be in this demand zone, okay? Nobody can really predict that. But if at all, we may bounce off the demand zone and then continue shifting lower. Why? Because we still have this liquidity. And if we don't bounce off there, then we're just going to rally all the way down, take out that liquidity, and then we'll decide what to do. So for me, 30K and maybe even 29K, 28K is actually viable. If I look at it, let's say 28,500 is actually viable. So whether it happens this week, it's still an area. And I keep on saying, just because you want the coin to go up because you want to make money in cryptocurrency doesn't mean it's going to go up. Yeah. And you can see with other coins, if you look at Ethereum, same thing. It's just been bearish. Last week was just a very interesting month. I mean, this is very bearish structure. And again, I look at this chart, I'm just like, guys, as soon as we took up this high, you know, and we broke down here, and this is evidence that we were headed down. Why anyone would want to buy this market? I don't know. So for Ethereum, we are actually approaching, we haven't yet gotten to the demand zone, but you're actually approaching a demand zone. So I'm seeing the next target will be 2164, at least at the near term, 2164.63. And again, liquidity resting downside. So we may even get lower to 1730. Okay, I know people don't want to hear that, but it's a possibility because we have liquidity lying at that level, which is 1710, thereabout, 1700s, okay? So yes, we are at 2400, but yes, 1700 is a possibility, but we do have a demand zone lying somewhere here that may cause a bump in that target short term. So you may see it come in here, maybe push up and then continue, take out that liquidity, and then we'll begin to see the rise. So right now, I think our major coins are all just headed down. Let me look at Litecoin, which is also another major coin. Same drill, guys. Liquidity line downside. Yeah, so I'm bearish on the major coins. Possibly on the altcoins, this, you know, we'd see difference in happening, because usually when the major coins are rallying, altcoins, are bearish, altcoins are probably going up. But then this last week, it looks like many coins, even altcoins, have just been, you know, dropping. Anyway, so that being said, yes, I'm looking at BTC once more, and I just think we are still headed to the 30K zone, 28K zone. I'm not a, you know, a fortune teller. So don't take my word for it. Do your own research, but just don't believe all the hype that, yeah, you know, 100K, 100K. It'll happen, but it's just not going to happen like that because we say so. Always look at the charts. Okay, guys? So I hope this has been of value. As always, thank you for tuning in. And see you soon, guys. Enjoy trading this week and make some money. Bye.